Welcome to the 7447 7-segment decoder lab. Here I am at Multisim and we're going to build our 7-segment decoder. So first thing let's do is let's go grab our components here. So we're going to need a 74LS. So let's grab a 7447. And let's grab a 7490. Good. So we're going to need an LED. So let's go back to indicators and hex display. And we're going to use a 7-segment. Common anode, because we're going to put a positive and we're going to use our 7447 to ground those. So there's ours, and we're going to need a resistor. So let's go back to basic and let's see if we have a resistor pack here. Resistor RPAC. Here we go, and we've got a 8-line, we've got 7 segments, so let's use a 7-segment isolated, and we're going to make him a 220. And we're going to need a ground, so we're going to go to power sources, ground. We're going to need a VCC. And that's okay. And let's see, we're going to need a clock. So we're going to get a signal for clock voltage. That's way out. Okay, let's spread out our components. We'll put a resistor in between there. Let's move that over. And there, this is going to be pretty straightforward. And we got our clock. Let's move them down here. And so we're going to need grounds on all these. So let's go ahead and spread out some grounds. Our VCCs, we're going to need a couple of those. Let's go ahead and spread some of those around. We're definitely going to need one for our, let's just move him over. We're going to need him for our LED. Oops. Get that there. Okay. So let's just go ahead and connect our resistors. Okay, so we're going to go A and B. We're going to connect all our resistors here to a 7447. Yeah, we need our resistor pack in between. So let's go ahead and connect our 7490. So we're going to go QA to A and QB to B and QC to C and QD there. Alrighty, so we're going to need, let's go ahead and take him down here. Let's move our ground. Let's just move him. Let's flip him vertically. Good. Get back. Oh man. Flip vertically. Good. So let's make sure our light test. And let's make sure our RVI are pulled high. Our blinking input should float. So we'll make sure that works here in a minute. So we're going to have our clock here. I think it's 5 kHz. Just leave it at 1K for now. Let's connect our ground. And these all should be connected to ground because they're AND gates and we don't want them to work. Okay. Let's see here. So we got everything over there, everything over there. So now we don't need that anymore. And what we're going to do is we're going to come off a QD, go back into the clock. Actually, we're going to go off a QA. And let's go ahead and I'll be back. Okay, I need to connect our blinking input. I think that may stop us from working on this. Let's just make it a little bigger, center it. All right, let's start it, see what happens. And it's telling us that we have internal power, which is good. Perfect, it's working good.